There's 50 decks in here, and I don't. Are you singing?
That's unexpected. I must say, you fight well.
Now put that in your pipe and smoke it.
Okay, good afternoon. This is Lucky Lynx. All right, so this particular video, I wanted to build on the last video that I built on, in which I was telling you guys. Well, there's a couple of them. One, I was telling you the difference between sympathy and compassion, and what happens also when you sort of expect others to make the decisions of your life, or you remove the responsibility of your own life and put it on someone else. You sort of outsource your life to other people. And that one seems to be getting a really strong response from folks, so I'm really glad that that's happening. And now I would like to talk a little bit more about a subject that I talk about frequently on this station, and that's wishes, and how wishes, why it's important that once you make a wish that you accept the wish and you rise to the occasion, or why it's really important that you not deny who you really are and you become who you really are because other people are relying on you. And this is really the point that I would like to hopefully succinctly drive home today. When you make a wish and you don't live up to it, or you don't rise to the occasion, what happens is other people suffer for that. Because usually when the conditions align for a wish or an invocation, or even those of you who call it an intention or a manifestation, whatever it is, usually it's not just one person that's involved. So let's say that you want more money, all right? You need money, you want money. Well, the guy down the street needs to pay his bills, the one over there needs to pay her bills, the one at the pedicure shop needs to pay their bills. You get money, you give the woman who does you the pedicure, you give her money, then she can pay her bills, you give the guy at the grocery store something, he can pay his bills, you give the people at the coffee shop money, and then those baristas get to be paid, and then everyone gets something because you got your wish, and you took it, and you used it for what you said you were going to use it. And that's just a small example. Now I'm going to give you a larger, more uncomfortable example here. Quite a few years ago, I knew an individual who was a farmer, and he actually made an invocation to the Tibetan wealth god for a bit of wealth. And he was in a situation where he wanted to go to an auction, and he wanted to buy a piece of antique farm equipment that he knew he could sell for a lot of money. So he made an invocation, he made a wish to the Tibetan wealth god that he could actually score this piece of farm equipment, and then he could sell it, he could make a good bit of money on it. Now, this isn't the only wish that he did that went wrong. I'm going to tell you a little bit more about that in a second. But in this particular case, what happened was he made the wish. He wanted the particular piece of farm equipment. He got the particular farm equipment. He went to the auction. He got the farm equipment. Now here's what happened. When the Tibetan wealth god gave him that particular piece of property, that was marked for the thing that he had made the wish for. That was to be for the prosperity that he wanted. So he was supposed to take it and he was supposed to sell it. When he got the thing home, he realized that it was in better condition than the one that he had. Now he started to covet it. He desired it. He wanted it. He wanted to own it. The whole reason that he'd made the wish and the whole reason the thing would come in was because he could give it to someone else. And then that person would have it. And then he would get the prosperity from it. And then he would be able to see it. He decided to keep it. Because it was shiny. It was bright. Well, it was his after all. He bought it. So then he started talking himself out of it. Well, I bought it. My money. So he had this piece of farm equipment that he didn't necessarily have any use for. Here's the other thing that was going on. This was an individual, too, who also found out what his core archetype was. He didn't necessarily want to be that archetype. He wanted to be another archetype. He didn't really see the talent that he could have as that particular archetype. Now, the archetype that he had as a farmer working on farm was a good one. He could have balanced and made sure that everyone, everything on the farm had what it needed, that all the animals had the attention they needed, that they had the medical care that they needed, that they had the food that they needed, that they had the space to run that they needed, that they could flourish, everyone could flourish. And if he had really lived from his core archetype, and he kept wishing to be a farmer so bad, he wanted to be a farmer so bad, he wanted to be a farmer so bad, he had the talents to do so. But instead of actually making sure that he lived from his core archetype and did what he needed to make sure that all the animals had what they needed, all the beings on the farm had what they needed, and that the farm was all balanced, he decided he wanted to be the other archetype. Instead of the one who gave and made sure that everyone had the balance that they needed, he wanted to be the archetype who built stuff. It didn't work out well for him. He was lousy at building things. Every time he tried to build something, it would malfunction. He built an incubator for a whole bunch of baby chicks, and he half-assed it, as he did everything else he built, because he wasn't living from the archetype or the core archetype he really was. He wasn't really living up to his wish to be a farmer who actually took care of and cared for everything. He got worried about resources, he got worried about money, he thought, oh, I don't have the money to do this right. So he built these things himself and he half-assed them. And the animals kept dying. The incubator killed all the chicks overnight, they froze to death. Because the motor went out and the poor little chicks froze to death. He had a cow, the cow was pregnant. She was a beautiful cow, she had a great personality, she gave great milk. And she was pregnant. There was prosperity at hand. Well, he wasn't paying attention to her. He wasn't paying attention to her needs. He was trying to manage and control everything in his life. He was doing other jobs. He was doing other things. Instead of living up to his wish to be a farmer and actually balance everything and give it what he needed, he was trying to take on all these other things in his life too. He was actually trying to take other people's problems as his own. He was trying to control things. He wanted to control everything. So instead of living up to his wish and being the farmer who could actually create prosperity on this land, what he did was trying to control everything and everyone, not paying attention to what really needed to be paid attention for his wish to be cultivated, the cow died. She went up on a hill in the middle of the night. There was complications with the birth. He didn't even know about it. She died. This was happening constantly with the animals on his farm. He wasn't coming from his core. He wasn't honoring the wish that he made. He wasn't being the individual that he was really supposed to be. He wasn't rising to the occasion and becoming better. He wasn't learning how to do his task better. He wasn't learning how to be who he was at his core better so he could actually make it all flourish. But he kept making wishes. I want more, I want more, I want more. But there never seemed to be enough. There never seemed to be enough because in his mind there was never enough. And when the wish came in, he didn't appreciate it. When the resources came in, he let them die, he let them go. He didn't take care of them, he didn't treasure them. In the end, he decided one more wish. He couldn't take it anymore. Everything was too much for him. Now, he hadn't really paid attention to the wishes that he made. He hadn't protected them. He hadn't nurtured them. He hadn't cared for them. And so what happened in the end? He got kicked in the head with a bull. He ended up in the hospital. He was out. And it was pretty devastating. After that, he had to go on disability. He was no longer allowed to be a farmer. It's not the prettiest story in the world, but it's a really good one that illustrates that when we make a wish and we don't rise to the occasion to actually fulfill and be the one who can actually nurture, care for, and bring that wish to greater fruitfulness, greater prosperity, other beings suffered. All of those other animals on the farm suffer. All of the people who could have prospered from what revenue came from the farm suffered. All of the friends who had to come in and try to help him to buck up the farm and do the work that he couldn't do his own because he was always thinking, well, there wasn't enough, and he wasn't really working the farm in a way that created great prosperity because he wasn't wanting to rise to something bigger than a struggling farmer, which is really where his mind was. He was a struggling farmer. And instead of embracing the systems, instead of hiring the people who could help him make it better, he's like, I'm struggling, there's never enough. So he didn't rise to become the individual that his wish demanded, and all of the other beings and people involved suffered. When you make a wish and you don't rise to the occasion, someone else is going to suffer. I had a wonderful example with someone yesterday who very graciously told me her story. She decided that in her life she wanted to get more healthy and to make herself much better. And she started to get into fitness, work out, and she was going to compete. And when she did so, she inspired her husband, who was having all sorts of health problems, who was on medication. He saw her become bigger. He saw her rise to a greater occasion. He saw her take care of herself. He saw her starting to compete as a bodybuilder, and he took himself off the drugs and didn't need them anymore and started to make himself healthier. when she decided all of a sudden as she started to succeed that she didn't want to succeed anymore and she started to let herself drop, he dropped too. So remember this. When you make a wish and you make a wish to become something bigger, you owe it to this world, this space, and the others involved to become that great thing. When you say, I don't want anything bigger, I just want to sit in my house, watch TV, and never become any bigger, you're denying the other people in the world who are relying on you to become something bigger, something greater, that can either inspire them, help them, touch them, or plug into something that they need you for. When you make a wish to do something, and you don't follow through with it, the other people who made that wish too, who are waiting for you, relying on you to plug into your piece, to bring your talents to the picture, when you don't become that person, they suffer too. This happens a lot of times with a group. Someone will wish for something and a group will come into being and they'll need all these different kinds of people to be part of it. And one person flakes out. Let's say that you got a play going on and a bunch of you want to put on a play and you need someone to play the lead role and someone to play this role and someone to play that role. Well, if this person who's the lead role decides that they don't want to do it, well, now you're left. You need someone still to fill that role, but there's no one to do it because the person who was supposed to do it, the person who was qualified to do it, the person who actually fit into that role, they decided for whatever reason they were going to back out. Maybe they were scared. Maybe they had excuses. Maybe they said, well, I can't afford it. Maybe they said whatever. Whatever it is. Just like the individual who had the farm, it didn't matter that he thought he couldn't afford it. The baby chick still died. It didn't matter that he wanted to control everything and thought he was in control and thought he was the great builder. That cow died. Doesn't matter what we think. Sometimes other people suffer because we're not rising to the occasion of who we are. You have someone at your core that you really are. And if you're not exploring who that is at your core, if you're not fully fulfilling yourself and getting actualizing yourself and getting the most out of the wishes that you make, you're actually cheating other people. You're cheating them of the treasure that you have to bring to the world and to different circumstances that they're actually relying on you to rise to. The mother or father who doesn't become independent, free, confident, and successful cheats the children because the children won't ever see the example of how to do that themselves. I'm Lucky Lynx, as always, wishing you success and good fortune in all that you do. And if you guys would like to learn to read the tarot, I have two classes on it. I have a beginning class, and I have an advanced, intermediate to advanced class. So if you'd like to sign up for that class, I would love to have you for that class. And contact me, 779-302-8009. Or conjurehope@gmail.com. Hey, I also have a Lenormand class. These are my Lucky Lynx Once Upon a Time Oracle cards. Each one is based on a fairy tale. For example, that's Dorothy from The Wizard of Oz. That's The House, which is The Three Little Pigs. That's The Rings, which is the first genie in the tale of the Arabian Nights. You want to learn how to read Lenormand like a boss, I've got a beginning Lenormand class and I've got a Grand Tableau class going right now. Contact me, I'll tell you how to get into those. I also have one in Mexican Loteria, how to read the Mexican Loteria, which is one of my favorite oracles to read. I also have one in how to read crystal balls, how to scry. It's not just crystal balls you learn. You learn how to scry in water, how to scry in salt, how to scry in crystal ball, and how to scry in an oracle that doesn't have any meanings. So. For those of you who actually would like to schedule a reading with me, same thing, 779-302-8009 or conjurehope@gmail.com. And hey, for those of you who've donated, I really appreciate the generous donations. If you would like to donate to help keep these videos coming, well, I'd love for you to do so. Thank you very much. I have my PayPal and my Venmo will be in the space below. Feel free to donate. Remember, when you don't rise to the occasion, when you don't become the greatest being that you can become, when you don't let your treasure out, when you don't become who you are at your core, you deny everyone else in the world who's actually relying on you to bring your treasures to the world. When you sit this one out, when you demand less of yourself, when you think it's not my job to become bigger, when you come up with excuses for why you can't face your fears, why you can't face your limits, and why you can't face those things that keep you sick, bound, and stuck. You're denying the rest of the world. And if you're not bringing your treasure to the rest of the world, what's your point of being here?